So I don't know if you guys are getting random ass messages from WhatsApp, if you even have WhatsApp. But about 30 minutes ago, I just got a message saying, "Hey, what's up? How are you?" Well, it was from an unknown number that I didn't have saved. Not to mention, it was international. So I did a little Googling. Comes to find out, they were messaging me from Turkey. I've been to Turkey, got friends in Turkey, love Turkey, and have stayed for a very long time. Then it dawned on me. So my last trip to Turkey, flew in from San Francisco. Got there, the airport was massive. I wasn't staying in Istanbul for that day. I was actually flying out and I was flying to Kayseri so I can get to Cappadocia. The story goes, I was asking everyone, how do I get from the international side to the domestic side? Because I only had about 45 minutes to be able to get there and get on my flight. Well, I missed that flight. The people were not helpful at all. Crazy part was there wasn't another flight for at least a good 6.5 hours. And this was one of the more weirder parts because I've never really experienced this ever in my life. I basically stayed overnight in an empty airport. So here's a video. When I tell you there was not one person in sight, as you can see, this is the first floor. I look down to see, is there anyone there? No one there. I'm on the second floor. There was no one on the second floor for as far as you could see. Literally, it was empty. So I went down to the bottom section where my flight would depart from. Again, extremely empty as far as you can see. I zoom in on this photo and you can see that there's literally no one anywhere at all in sight. It was like a ghost town. So I finally arrived. It's like 3 a.m. in the morning, and I am like out of my mind. Luckily, they have a driver from the hotel that's there to pick me up and take me to the place. Now, when I tell you the Radisson in other countries are nothing like the Radisson in America. So to give you a better understanding as to where I was, this is Kayseri, and I needed to get from here to Cappadocia. Now, Cappadocia is also referred to as Gorime, which is a national park. So I need to get from there to there. So you can see the distance is pretty far. So I didn't sleep that long. I woke up, this is about 7 a.m. I opened the shades because I heard some religious prayers, and I thought I'd take a look to see what Kayseri looked like from my view. So I packed my things and I headed downstairs to get a complimentary breakfast, but there was just one big issue that I had. There was no Lyft, there was no Uber, there was no shuttle to actually take me to Cappadocia. So I talked to the guy at the front desk and he was like, "Oh yeah, I know someone that can actually take you. He charges this much." I've never been in a situation where I've just gotten in a car with a stranger in a completely different country that I've never met before. That was a little weird to me. But I had to get to Cappadocia, so here we are, in the car, on the way, random stranger, and yeah. So if you've never heard of Cappadocia, this is exactly what it is. It's all the hot air balloons that you see going up into the air. This is fun and it's exciting and it's something that I really wanted to do. But unfortunately for me, I haven't had much sleep. I think I've had 4 hours worth of sleep in the past 24 hours, so I'm really tired. In order to get on one of these hot air balloons, you have to be up at like 3 a.m. But the great part of this story is I did not wake up at 3 a.m., but I did wake up at 7:30 a.m. and I was still able to see a little bit of the balloons in the sky. I also had a nice early breakfast there, and this was a great experience. But the person who ended up texting me was the driver who drove me from Kayseri to Cappadocia. He was checking to see when I was going to return to Turkey. And how was everything going? So sometimes random scary events can actually be something pretty cool.